Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. So in the previous tutorial we saw what is decorator and how to create it. In that we took two examples. In the first example we took a function without any parameter, and in the second example we took a function which contained two parameters. So we saw how to decorate a function without parameter, also with parameter. And in this tutorial we'll discuss more about the decorators. So first we'll see how to use multiple decorators, okay, on single function. And next we'll see if decorator contains parameter, then how to use it, decorator with parameters. In the previous example we saw function with parameter. If decorator itself contains parameter, then how to use it, we'll see today. And lastly, how to use a single decorator on multiple function, that is nothing but how to write the general decorator. Okay, so we'll discuss about these three concepts today. So first is how to use multiple decorator on single function. Okay, so for that, here first we'll take a function. Okay, so a ordinary simple function, it will return a message like good morning. Alright, so now I want to decorate it. What I want to do is, I want to first change the case of this. So for that I can use uppercase decorator. I can create a decorator. In that I can use upper method. That is we discussed in the previous tutorial, right? I can do that. And next, as well as I want to split this string. So here I'll declare two decorator function. So the first function is simple, that is upper decorator. I won't explain anything here because this is the same example which we took in the previous tutorial. Alright, same, right? So here I'll define another function which will split the string. Here also func, a function, and here I'll take inner function as wrapper. You can take any name, I don't want any parameter. Here I'll take str2 and I'll call the function, because to split the string I want string, and for that I'm calling the function return str2 split. Okay, so next return wrapper. Okay, so this function will take this string and it will split that and it will return that. This will take this string, okay, it will convert it to uppercase letter and it will return it. Okay, so now here I need to use the decorator names at. First I'll use upper D. Okay, next above it I'll split, okay, and next here I'll call this ordinary function. So we are getting this good and morning. This string is converted to uppercase letter and as well as it is splitted. So here first it will apply this upper decorator on it. So it will convert the string to uppercase. Next it will apply that split decorator on this function. We'll get the splitted string. Okay. So here if I interchange this order. So here first this decorator will apply, that is upper decorator. After that it will apply. If I interchange it, here we'll get the error, because I'll show you. I'll place here and if I save this and run this, we'll get the error. So because when we apply this split decorator function on it, it will return the splitted string in the list form. Okay, now I can't apply this upper function on the list, right? That's why we are getting the error. So we need to be careful about this outcome of the functions. Okay, so in this way we can use multiple decorator in the single function. Here we can see first, second, good morning, second, first. So first this will apply. Okay, so it will do second this message, good morning, second. Next, after that this will apply. That's why first, second, the good morning message, second, first, we'll get output like this. Okay, in this way multiple decorator function will work. So next is, if a decorator contains parameter, then how to use it? Okay, so for this what I'll do is, I'll take one single function. So I'll delete this. Okay, so if I want to use the parameter in the decorator function, then I need to take a function. Inside that I need to define this decorator function. Okay, so that's nothing but here initially I need to take the function, one outside function. It should contain the expression, that is nothing but whatever the parameter. Okay, and next here we need to define this. So here I'm not doing anything, just I'll call the function plus, here I'll take the expression. Okay, so here next, sorry, return upper here at the outer, here the expression I'll take a name. Okay, so I'll take my name only. Why I'm taking the space, because otherwise it won't print the space after this. Okay, that's why only. So if you want, here you can give space and here you can remove that. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, good morning Amulya. Okay, so here if you want to pass a parameter to the decorative function, then you need to take a function. Inside that you need to define the decorative function. Okay, so this is the outer function, this is the decorator function, and you can pass like this. Okay, so here it will print that. Okay, so this is about how we can take the parameter to the decorators. So next is how to write the general decorator function, which can be used on multiple function. Okay, so if I say multiple function means, here I'll take an example. Okay, I'll take a function called divide. Here I'll take two parameters, okay, a, b, and it will return a divided by b. Okay, so next I'll take another function, I'll call it as div2. It will take three parameters, then return a divide b divide c. Okay, so to call this function, what I can do, I can call div1 div2. To print this result, I should print, pass the parameter like 10 and 20. One, two, three. Okay, so like this. Okay, so here I defined two function, one is division one, division two, which will do the same thing, that is it will divide the numbers, but here we took two parameters, here three parameters. Okay, here in this function call, if this value becomes zero, the second value becomes zero, it will raise an divide by zero error. Here also, if any of this value becomes zero, then it will raise the divide by zero error like this. I'll show you. Here we can see divide by zero error for the second function call. Okay, so to manage this, what I'll do is, I'll define a decorator function which will work for these two function. Okay, so we'll define a general decorative function which can be applied on the multiple function. So for that I'll take def and here I'll take decorative function as, okay, so here I need to take the function, and here I need to take the next function inner. Here we can see this function contains two parameters, this contains three, right? So that's why what I'll do is I'll use here star and r. Okay, so that is nothing but I can use multiple arguments here now. So here now I need to check whether the second value becomes zero or the second or third value becomes zero. For this, what I'll do is I'll take a list one, empty list. Okay, here I'll take list one is equal to args. So it will give the list of the parameters. Okay, so this is the special keyword which allows the function to take variable length argument. Okay, it allows us to take variable number of non-keyworded arguments. So here name you can take anything. Okay, so here if I take one onwards, because I don't care about the first parameter, right? Here it can be zero or anything, I don't care about that, but the parameter present after the first argument, it should not be equal to zero. If it is zero, then rise the divide by zero error, right? That's why here I took like this. Okay, I'll check whether here any zero is present. For that I'll take for I in list one. Okay, if I is equal to zero, then return give proper input. Okay, else here return function return inner. Okay, so here using this we can use variable length arguments, and here this is just to check whether the second parameter or the second, third, fourth parameter are zero or not. Okay, if it is zero, then I need to return this message, else I need to execute this function. Okay, so here I'll take okay and I'll copy this also, paste. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, give proper input, here we can see zero, that's why. So it won't raise the divide by zero error. Okay, instead of here, if I take nine here, here zero, give proper input. Instead of this, now if I take here zero, the first argument as zero, it will give the result. Okay, here also if I take this as zero, give proper input, it will print this message. Okay, so like this it will execute. So in this way you can use the decorators. First you can use multiple decorator on a single function, you can use decorator with parameters, and you can write a general decorator, like we can use a decorator on multiple functions of different variable length. Okay, so this is about the decorators. In the next tutorial also we'll continue the discussion on this. Okay, so that's it for now guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.